doctor, really speaking, is not what my disease is, but am I going to die? And am I going to have to miss the school tomorrow? Like, that would be like a celebratory thing for you, but you know, right? So you, given some number of symptoms, you want the doctor to tell you whether other symptom also will happen. The symptom that everybody is interested in is, would I die, right? Okay, so you can actually compute the next symptom's likelihood based on the symptoms that you have seen till now. Just like you want to compute the next data based on the current data you have seen until now. In here, we considered this hypothesis as an intermediary between the data, right? So the data causes the hypothesis which causes the data. Okay, and similarly, in the medical diagnosis community, you essentially invented this notion of diseases and even syndromes. And you say, based on your symptoms, the chance that you have this disease, this syndrome is this much. And I have a little textbook which says, based on this syndrome, the chance that it will cause this symptom is this much. Then I would be able to, so for example, here is the interesting thing. You, based on your symptoms, either you could be suffering from Ebola or common cold, 0.5, 0.5, let's say. Right? Suppose it turns out that common cold, you will have runny nose tomorrow. Ebola, you will have runny nose along with all other runny things. Right? Now, what's the probability of runny nose tomorrow? It's 1.0. Because either you're suffering from Ebola or common cold. Whereas a doctor who wants to pick one disease, and only one disease, will say you only have 50% chance of getting common cold tomorrow. Picking winners is not a good idea. We pick winners because of intellectual laziness. That's what Bayesians tell you. Picking winners is a reasonable idea if in fact your distribution is such that one guy is way above everybody else. In which case, whether you picked or not picked, it would have made a difference. Whereas if the entropy of the distribution is high, such that many diseases are equally likely, picking one of them and only treating you for that is an iffy thing. Do you see what I'm saying? So, medical diagnosis and full Bayesian learning are one and the same. And you heard of medical diagnosis when you learned elementary probabilistic reasoning. You look at the symptoms, you compute the probabilities of diseases. Based on the probability of diseases, you compute the probabilities of other symptoms. And so the last point for today's class is, for Bayesians, there is no such thing as learning. So Bayesian learning is an oxymoron. There is nothing different from Bayesian inference and Bayesian learning. Then the question is, why are we picking winners? Normally, learning means picking a winning hypothesis. That's what you have heard of before. Okay? Based on the examples, I pick a winning hypothesis. Based on that, I will then decide what the label would be next. When you come back next class, we'll essentially find out that there is trouble in the paradise. Because, you know, in this particular case, luckily enough, you had 5 hypotheses. What if you had 1500 hypotheses? What if your hypothesis was a continuous hypothesis space? That means you have infinite number of hypotheses. Okay? Essentially, while conceptually it's a beautiful thing, figuring out how to compactly represent the posterior over the hypothesis becomes tricky. So, again, because of the intellectual laziness, we will, you know, people essentially have converted the Bayesian learning into, you know, either to map, where you pick a winning hypothesis based both on the likelihood of the hypothesis plus the likelihood of the data given the hypothesis, or maximum likelihood, where you don't even care about the likelihood of the hypothesis. You just pick the prior likelihood of the hypothesis, doesn't matter. Whichever is more consistent with the data is the one you pick. And it turns out that these guys work the same as Bayesian learning for the large data case. Because if the data just keeps coming without bound, then all your prior observations don't matter, because the data will eventually decide what the posterior is. But for the small data case, it makes a huge difference. Okay, so we will understand that and we'll spend time in doing statistical learning with maximum likelihood and also Bayesian learning. Okay.